Where did this journey start? That's a loaded question. I did not think that these guys will ever be basketball players.
To be honest, we all sucked back then. We didn't win any games. And I think we've lost like every tournament for weeks and weeks in a row.
Eighth grade, let's fast forward to eighth grade. And again, just struggling in a game that we should win by 30. And I'm thinking these guys are the future high school varsity players. Like the school, AGBU didn't have that many really good players coming up. So these guys as freshmen, they needed to move up to varsity right away. And I'm thinking, if we can't win a tournament like this, what are we gonna do? How are we gonna succeed in high school?
A dangerous virus is spreading rapidly in China, and U.S. officials are very worried that it could come here.
The deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S. Here's what we know.
So, COVID time, it was leading into their sophomore season. We had no idea if we're even going to have a season, but through that uncertainty, we were just working out every day.
Coach Nareg would come to my house every single day, and I would actually train with my little brother outside.
Every day, I would just make my rounds, and we'd be working out outside in their backyards.
I wanted to go get a workout in the beginning, but then I started enjoying it when Coach Nareg came, and it was like, I felt like I was part of a family, like a small little group.
When I saw that my brother and his teammates were gonna get workouts in, I thought I should just try and get better. Maybe I can make the team. I saw that a lot of the good players, really good players like Matthew, my older brother, and Auden were all coming to my house to get some work in. I just thought I should try and see what I can do and if I can be on the same level as these guys, and it ended up working and I got better over the summer.
I remember I was going to their houses wearing a triple mask in 112 degree weather. I'm sweating. I get in my car one of the days and I'm thinking, I mean, we're getting better, yeah, but what's next? I didn't know what the future held. Finally, we got the news that we got to play league games. Ended up winning 8 league games in a row. We were undefeated league champions. It was actually the first time since 2004 that we were league champs.
It comes playoffs, first two rounds, easy-ass games. We won both of them. And then a semifinal game versus Calvary Chapel. It was a big crowd, big school, all bands, everything like that.
The gym was absolutely insane. There was a band taking up half the gym. This was the first time they made it that far too. And the guys couldn't even hear me. That was the first time that guys couldn't hear me. So my play calls were all just off signs.
We couldn't hear our players, or they couldn't hear us. And we were making signs so they understand what's going on.
It was a heartbreaking loss actually. We lost by 3 points. And I remember walking out the gym and saying, we ever get to this point again? What are we supposed to do from here? Obviously, we had state coming up, but I'm thinking, do you know how difficult it was to get to this point?
I'll never forget that moment, especially that I'm graduated now, and I'll never forgive myself for missing those free throws. But yeah, 10th grade year was a roller coaster, and I ended up getting surgery right after the season ended, which did affect half of my 11th grade year.
We go undefeated that year. Let's fast forward through everything. We go undefeated. We win league. I mean, we're just running through teams. And a lot of writers are now looking at AGBU and saying, okay, this is interesting. This small Armenian school is 21-0. And this is the first time the school has gone undefeated. Actually, it's the first time in a lot of schools that somebody's gone undefeated. I'm looking at CIF records, and we're getting ready for playoffs. At this point, I'm thinking, oh, we're a high seed. We're set. We lead into playoffs. First game, we get our draw, and we're playing against Leylekian of Long Beach. And we end up a dream 21-0 season, losing in the first round.
That was a very shocking and confusing moment for all of us. Like, we all had to take a step back because for a moment we forgot how to lose a game. So that loss just hit really differently since we didn't lose in over like a year.
I wish we were more used to losing, because when we were down and we were panicking, we would have been more prepared and I think we would have pulled out the win.
That was probably the worst I've ever felt in my basketball career ever. We got sent home in the first round, and that was the biggest heartbreak ever. And since 2 days after that, we went straight to practices. We got to work, workouts.
Everyone was just so pissed that I would say maybe we took 2 days off. And we're right back to work. Right back to work, ARPS rehabbing. Everybody's in the gym. And I mean, we were working. We got another playoff game coming up. While the playoffs are still going on, we're in the gym preparing for the next season. It was a great regular season run, something that we'll never forget. Who wins 21 games in a row? That's not what you hear every day. So now we got all these writers saying, okay, this AGBU team returns majority of their core the following year. Let's follow them. So it was off season, and I'm sitting in my office, and I get a call from Vic. And Vic goes, oh man, I'm sorry. And I started laughing. I said, what? I'm trying to refresh the CIF page to figure out what division we're in.
We're on the phone together, and finally it populated on my phone, and I don't see us. We were in 3A last year, and I'm looking at 3A, we're not there. I looked at Division 4, we're not there. I looked at 3AA, we're not there. And I look, we're in Division 2.
I almost dropped my phone. We got bumped to Division 2. And I'm thinking, I don't even know what I'm thinking at this point. I know our team is really good, but are we a Division 2 team? So many questions going through my mind. And I texted in our group chat right away, and I said, guys, you know, we're a Division 2A basketball team.
So I remember when Coach Nodic sent us a text that we're in D2, all of my friends and teammates were like, oh, damn, we're in D2, like, it's going to be tough. But I was like, nah, we're good. We got this.
So we get to the first game of season, much anticipated. Our building is packed. LA Times just published the article. Everybody, even that writer is here, saying, all right, let's see what these guys are made of. Yeah, we got upset. We're playing Shalhevet. A very well-prepared team. They know us inside and out. So we get into this game and we lose, and we don't know how to lose at this point. Everyone's just fighting. And
I think that loss really changed all of us, because the year before we didn't lose a game. We didn't know how it was to lose. So I think that game actually really helped us throughout the whole year, because now that taught us how a loss felt, and that just made every game more important. I'm a deleted, she my little secret. You trying to dish me to blow up, I peep it. I can't respond, we just go at your people. If I left some rats on the bed, you can keep it. Getting deeper and deeper, I dig it. My shovel won't be in, I was broke, had to fix it. A shark in the water, you swim with a little fish. I hit the day, by tomorrow she miss it. I grab a net, she look up, then I kiss it. I'm not a goat, but I fit the description. I like the post, so I get the prescription. We walk around with them bands and I breach it. This gun ain't gon' jam when I blow, I ain't missing. I'm dropping hit after hit, I'm just chilling. But I send a hit while I chill with my children. Bigger the business, the bigger the office. I found and found me a shred and I caught up. They call for my artists, they making me offers. I don't even bargain, I start from the bottom. I lost a Ferrari, Las Vegas, Nevada. I woke up the following day and went harder. I'm cracking my shell, now they see that I'm smarter. I gotta get money, I love to get charter. I gave them 4 burgers at once for a startup. I can't let them down, walk around with my guard. I'm screaming out YOLO, yeah, that's still the motto. I know I be on some, they ain't thought of. Sins, I got sins on my mind and some M's. Got a lot of M's.
leading into the Walnut game, which was a championship game of the West Covina tournament, we had been on an 8-game winning streak. Lose the game by 10, 11 points, and it was just a really good test for us. And I'll remember that game as the moment where we realized that Division II is not going to be the worst thing in the world and that we could hang.
So heading into the second Pili Bowls game, we had already beat them once. Much anticipated by the Armenian community. There was a lot of people in the gym. We're away. Now we find ourselves down by 2 with about 1.3 seconds left.
So we're down 2. Coach calls a timeout and the plays for me. So we break out the timeout. At this point, for some reason, I'm just very calm. I don't know. There's like a feeling in me. I went to my cousin and my brother and all his friends. I'm like, watch this. I just run up half court, get the ball from Michael, turn around, face, shoot it. And then the rest is history.
So season's about to end. We're 20-4. A lot of hate messages leading into playoffs saying you guys have no chance. And we get Pasadena High School first round.
Every basketball high school critic or whatever was saying that a school size like Pasadena have a school size of 3,000, 2,000. For us to have only a school size of 200, it was unheard of for the Steve Mbia matchup or a game. So we had so much pressure on us, but so little pressure at the same time. But we hold ourselves to such a high standard that there's no option to lose.
There were writers before the game that wrote about how we stood no chance against Diamond Bar. I actually saved all the articles just so after the game, when I tweet out the score, I make sure I include all of them into the tweet so they know, you know, get their facts straight.
Going into our quarterfinal game, we were matched up against Adelanto. We game planned very well and we took a lot of time to nitpick and look at every one of their weaknesses, strengths. It would be our first semifinal appearance since 10th grade and it was a really pivotal win for us.
Zipper, let him go all the way through. Well, tonight is the playoff game. The AGBU Titans take on number one ranked Rancho Christian in Temecula in a semifinal game. Both teams have already qualified for the state tournament, which begins February 28th. Now, if the Titans win tonight, they will advance to the Southern Section Finals for the first time in the school's history.
Don't think about it too much, too much, too much, too much.
And I really truly believe that we are supposed to be in this division. You are where you are, not by accident. Done saying, I'm done playing. Last time is on the outro. We can compete. You're in this game. Okay, this first 5 minutes will dictate everything. All right, let's come out hard. Let's watch out. Let's board.
And if your first 5 minutes is not a way cheap toy, it's only 1 game. Nothing. Start off 8-0.
Let's go. Guys, on three. 1, 2, 3, guys. Listen, I would be worried right now if it was over. I'd be sad if it was over, but it's not over. But we got now state to worry about.
We ended up losing the game by 19 points. And I mean, nothing to hang our heads on. Look how many people we brought to the game. Whole community was bought into what we were doing. And I told them after the game, we got state to look forward to.
We play our brand of basketball. You come out of this game with a win. You've been here, you've done this, you beat better teams than this. You are not an underdog. You belong here, you already know this, but you gotta play basketball in order to win. You understand? Stay disciplined, stay together. Let's come out, let's punch them in the mouth right away, and let's take care of business on your home court, man. It's a state playoff game, do or die. Let's take care of our stuff today.
Game close.
Now it's our turn to make a run. You make a run, you're at home, you punch them in the mouth, and we win this game.
Come on, man. You guys get everything. Thank you. Thank you for the four greatest years of my life, man. I would trade this for anything.
How much better can I show my love for you than say I do, I do, I do?
It's okay, bro. I don't know what to say, bro.
Pull up and I flood it with a iced out watch. Whip it look like butter, baby. Pecan drop.
Pecan.
Put that phone in the drop. Stammer ass. Count a lot. Saw a lot. Got on rocks. Diamond rocks. Whip the pot. Source size 1600. That's the block. Your girl is check free. She ain't used to text me. Now she won't caress me. She keep trying to neck me. I gotta tell my bestie. Someone call my bestie. Think I found my bestie. Link up with the check through. You know that I'm smoking dope. At the house in that tree. You know I'm cause she can't arrest me.
I was gonna say the word.
My toolie, what they do? Meet me in the alley with the troops.
Ties on 3, 1, 2, 3 times.
We're basically a brotherhood. To me, the ties that I have with the other players and the coaching staff go much deeper than basketball.
It's not about those individual accolades, though. It's more about the brotherhood. These are guys that have worked so hard in the last 4 years to get to where they've come, and I wouldn't choose anybody else to go on this journey with.
Can you just cut that out? It was good until then.
I don't know what to say.
Is that good or no?
Okay.